to another edition of BDPS News Flash. This is where we bring you news in a flash, inform you about how it affects you and make you think.
I am Jessica from 4 Compassionate.
And I am Jinghan from 4 Resilient.
To recap, in the last news flash, we spoke about how the number of retrenchments in Singapore increased during the first half of the year.
So now, back to our news flash. Which news article are we focusing on today, Jessica?
Today, we will be looking at an article that is very saddening.
Ooh, I am curious now to know what it is. Spill it, Jessica.
Today, we will be talking about how wildfires may decimate forests worldwide. Decimate means to destroy or remove a large area of forests.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Let's talk more about this matter. What happened?
Well, climate change has really affected our environment. Many forest wildfires across the world happen because of climate change.
Forests play an important role in maintaining levels of carbon dioxide gas in the air. They act as carbon sinks where they remove the gas faster than it being released into the air.
However, human activities like deforestation have reduced these forested areas, thus reducing their effectiveness as carbon sinks.
This year, record fires have raged in the United States, Australia, Argentina, and the Siberian Arctic. In the US, wildfires have always been natural, as much as the changing of seasons.
But now, they are more frequent and ferocious. These wildfires could end up wiping out some forests forever. As of Sunday, September 20th, wildfires in the US had devoured a record of about 2 million hectares. That's the size of about 2 million football fields.
In the past, fires in the region tended to burn loads of ground. This helped to remove dead plants and allowed pine cones to disperse their seeds.
But these days, fire crews are seeing increasing cases of the massive tree-torching fires that engulf forests from the ground up to the canopy.
If fires sweep a forest too frequently, they'll wipe out saplings before they can reach maturity.
Too hot, and the fires can turn large areas of the forest unsuitable for seeds to grow.
Wildfires can also occur in Australia as a result of hot and dry weather.
Scientists in Australia are already seeing evidence that fire is reshaping landscapes, possibly permanently. A series of unusually frequent fires in southeastern Australia since 2003 had caused forest systems there to collapse.
This means that forested states are turning into non-forested states already. No forests, no trees.
Even more worrying is an increase in wildfires in the Siberian Arctic. They can thaw permafrost, which are grounds that remain completely frozen.
This will cause a release of methane gas that will further warm up the world. Why did it happen?
Climate change has made these landscape-changing wildfires a concern worldwide.
Oh no! Tell me more!
Because of climate change, the weather has become warmer, causing it to be more difficult for trees to regenerate. So if there were multiple fires in those areas, the trees will not grow back.
That could be harmful to us too.
Yes, this will affect us in the long run if nothing is being done to slow this down. Let's watch a video to find out more about this problem.
It becomes so much more risky to actually have that spark light a fire under climate change. So we know because of research from scientists that we have 500% more risk for wildfires during this climate-changed world than we would have before. And that's because it's really hot and dry, because we have had droughts, and of course that drought, which is caused by climate change, has led to a lot of vegetation dying, meaning there's a lot of brush lying around that can easily light up, and a little spark from a gender reveal party or whatever it is can end up being a massive inferno very quickly. So of course people need to be careful and be held accountable when they light fires, but the fact is climate change is the real culprit behind what we're seeing right now.
We should mention too, California's fire record
This problem, although not in Singapore, affects us too. But there's a way that we can help.
Singapore has already been planting trees all around our nature reserves. This is part of our forest restoration plan.
We aim to plant 1 million trees by 2030 to create more gardens and nature parks. Can you think of more ways to help the environment?
So what have we learned today?
We have become more aware about other dangers that climate change can bring. This time, it is wildfires.
That's right. So we need to put in a more conscious effort to be environmentally friendly so that we can slowly heal this planet.
This links to our school value of respect. We have to respect the environment by making sure that we practice good environmental actions.
We need to also be responsible by taking good care of our planet for the future generation.
From this newsflash, it gives me a sense of reality as climate change brings out many disastrous effects on this planet.
It gives me a sense of hope too, as I believe that it's not too late to make a positive change in our lifestyles so that we can slow down the effects of climate change.
It also gives me a will to act. We must take action to try and prevent climate change from getting worse.
With that, we have come to the end of BGPS Newsflash.
Thank you and goodbye.
All right, very good morning, BGPians. Thank you for the students who have presented Newsflash this morning. Now, today marks the start of our very last term and the fourth week. I last addressed you 2 weeks ago in week two, and I shared with you how term four is going to pan out over the next few weeks. Okay, as you know, currently P6s are having their PSLE. Today is the third day of their PSLE, and it's going to be over very, very soon. By this Wednesday, the PSLE will be over. After that, the P3s, 4s, and 5s, you will be having your examinations for your semester assessment 2, okay, in week 7. So for the P1s and 2s, you will still be undergoing your usual non-weighted assessment. Now, I'd like to encourage all of you, do not just live your life based on exams and tests, but more importantly, continue to have a good habit of learning and keep learning and learning. Have a thirst for knowledge. Keep reading your books. Be resilient even when you find that it is difficult to learn or you find challenges. Learn new words every day and pick yourself up even when you fall down. On this short note, I'd like to just show you a very simple clip about a person or a sportsman, a gymnast actually, whose name is Diego Hipólito. He is a gymnast who participated in the Olympics in 2008, 2012, as well as 2016, and he's a Brazilian sportsman. His story is a very interesting one, and I thought I'll just show you a very short clip of what he has done. All right, the video please. I hope you enjoyed a very short video about Diego Hipólito. As you can see from the video and what he said at the end, he said that in 2008, I participated in the Olympics and I fell down on my backside. In 2012, I took part in London and I fell down on my face. In 2016, I landed on my feet and I could hold my head up high. What's the moral of the story? 8 years. He took 8 years to fulfill his dream of winning a medal in the Olympics in Rio de Janeiro. Earlier part of the year, I started sharing about our very own Olympian, Joseph Schooling, and how he had to train for so many years as well. And he also went through failures. He fell down, he jumped into the pool and got his goggles mixed up. And through it all these experiences helped him to be a better man. So to all students, I would like to encourage you. Even when you fall down, you must pick yourself up. Likewise, a special note to the P6ers. Okay? Regardless of whether you think you have done well for the first two papers or not, don't look behind, but look forward. Look forward, press on, and focus on what's ahead. And believe that you will do even better. So that's all I have for you this morning. I wish you a very happy term 4, week 4, and continue to press on in your learning. Persevere and you will succeed. See you.